Hi, my name is Bashar Taqi, and today I'll be talking about a feature called reputation monitoring. Reputation monitoring allows you to look at and monitor your IP address and domain's reputation across the web. This is done automatically every 12 hours by checking your IP addresses and domains against our list of block lists that we have and reputational databases to let you know the latest information about your domain reputation. To get started with reputation monitoring, we can configure a group that contains IP addresses, domains, and IP ranges so that we can start the monitoring feature. So heading over to the configuration tab here, I can click on the add button. This will prompt me to enter the group name, the asset types, the frequency of check, which is default at 12 hours, and notification integration. Notification integration we can set up by clicking this link, where you can add in any email addresses or also configure webhooks via Discord, Slack, or any other feature that supports webhooks so that you can receive any notification on any changes on your IP reputation immediately. So let me populate this table and go ahead with configuring the different types of records we support. Just as a side, you can easily configure your reputation monitoring. Easily configure your notification integration by clicking the add button on the page here, selecting the name, the email, and you can add in a URL to Discord, Slack, or any other service that supports this to then configure your webhook. Now I have created a new monitoring rule called demo, which monitors the following assets: the domain dmarctest5.com and the following two IP addresses. As I mentioned, the frequency of check will be every 12 hours, and I have set up a notification integration called example notification here, which will be used for any alerts regarding this group. So once that's done, I can click the add button here, and then it will create that group and then populate the summary page. There will be an initial check done once the group is created on any IP addresses and domains listed. Once that's done, there will be a new check every 12 hours to make sure that the data you receive on this dashboard is the most up-to-date data available. Of course, you can edit or delete or also disable any group that you have created using the action buttons here. So in our case, let's go ahead and edit this so that I would like to add in a new IP range that I would like to monitor. So clicking the add button here, let me just add in the range, let's say 2.3.4.5 with the range 32. Clicking enter or the tick button here, we'll add this into my selected items, and upon the next check that happens in the next 12 hours, we will now add in the new asset that we have created. Let's go on to the summary page to see what data you would actually receive. On the summary page, I can now see that the initial check has been done, and immediately I can see what blocklist, whitelist, and watchlist IP addresses exist within my group. So on the dashboard here, I can see that I have two whitelisted IP addresses or domains and two blocklisted IP addresses or domains. So clicking on either box, so let's say I would like to look at my blocklist, I can see that these two IP addresses are found in more than one reputational database. Whereas if I go to the whitelist, I can see that we automatically whitelist your domain and that the IP range that I have set is not on any reputational databases that we have on our portal. To get a quick overview as well, you give you the breakdown. So let's say you have a large multitude of IP addresses and domains. You can see them clearly here, and you can see how many of your IP addresses are blocklisted, watchlisted, or whitelisted. Of course, we explained what each category represents. So in this case, blocklisted if they are on more than one database. A watchlist is if it is on exactly one reputational database, and whitelist is that it is not on any of the reputational databases. Of course, with the notification integration, anytime there's a change, so let's say a new IP address gets watchlisted or blocklisted, you receive a real-time alert letting you know exactly which IP address or domain that was. You can also view and monitor your alert history here to see when or where this blocklisted happened. So this last check was done here once we added in the actual IP addresses. And we can see that it is on two blocklists and seven different blocklists for the two IP addresses respectively. Clicking this will actually let you know which blocklists this IP address is on, the type of asset and the number of blocklists. So let's take the example of 1.2.3.4. I can see that's on 7 different blocklists, and these are the blocklists it is listed on. With all this information, you'll be able to safely and accurately monitor your domain and IP reputation using this comprehensive feature that we have here.